Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we shall discuss the L'Hopital's rule. Till now, we have studied that when x tends to a, then limit f of x by g of x is equal to limit f of x by limit g of x, where limit of g of x is not equal to 0, as division by 0 is a meaningless operation. Thus, this rule on limits fails to give any information regarding the limit of a fraction where denominator tends to 0 as its limit. Now let us discuss some cases when denominator g of x tends to 0 as x tends to a. Now when g of x tends to 0 as x tends to a, then the numerator f of x may or may not tend to 0. Now, if f of x does not tend to 0, then f of x by g of x cannot tend to any finite limit. Let, if possible, it tends to a finite limit, say L, so we write f of x is equal to f of x by g of x into g of x. Now taking limits on both the sides, we have limit of f of x is equal to limit f of x by g of x into g of x, which is equal to limit f of x by g of x into limit g of x, which is equal to L into 0, as limit f of x tends to a finite limit by our supposition, and this is equal to 0, that is limit f of x is equal to 0. Thus we have a contradiction. Therefore, three types of cases are possible. 1. Fraction may tends to plus infinity. 2. Fraction may tends to minus infinity. 3. Limit does not exist. 4. Example, limit 1 upon x raised to power 2n as x tends to 0 is equal to plus infinity. If we put the value of x as 0 in this expression, we get 1 upon 0, that is plus infinity. 2. Limit 1 upon minus of x raised to power 2n as x tends to 0 is equal to minus infinity. If we put the value of x as 0 in this expression, we get 1 upon minus of 0, that is equal to minus infinity. could limit 1 upon x cube as x tends to 0 does not exist, as limit 1 upon x cube is equal to plus infinity as x tends to 0 plus, and limit 1 upon x cube is equal to minus of infinity as x tends to 0 minus, that is, left hand limit is not equal to the right hand limit. Therefore, the limit does not exist. Now we'll discuss the indeterminate form. There are cases when the numerator of a fraction is also zero, or in other words, we can say that a fraction where both numerator and denominator tend to 0 as x tends to a is known as an indeterminate form that is 0 by 0 form when x is equal to a. Now let us discuss the rule called the L'Hopital's rule. It uses derivatives and evaluates limits involving indeterminate forms and converting it into determinate forms. That is, if f of t and g of t and their derivatives are all continuous at x is equal to a and f of a is equal to g of a, that is, limit f of t as t tends to a is equal to limit g of t as t tends to a, then limit f of t by g of t is equal to limit f dash of t by g dash of t as t tends to a, provided g dash of t is not equal to 0. Now let us consider a curve passing through the origin and defined by the equations x is equal to f of t and x is equal to g of t. Let x, y be the coordinates of a point P on the curve near the origin. Suppose A to be the value of t corresponding to the origin say that f of a is equal to 0 and g of a is equal to 0. Also we have limit y upon x is equal to the limit tan of angle PON. Since tan of angle PON is given by perpendicular upon base, that is PN upon ON, given by y by x, which is equal to limit dy by dx. As x tends to a, hence limit f of t by g of t as t tends to a is equal to limit f dash of t by g dash of t as t tends to a. Here we don't differentiate f of t by g of t by quotient rule of differentiation, but we differentiate the numerator and denominator separately. If f dash of t and g dash of t is not of the form zero by zero, when t is assigned value zero, then we have limit f of t by g of t as t tends to a is equal to f dash of t by g dash of t. But if f dash of t by g dash of t is also of indeterminate form, then we repeat the process limit f dash of t by g dash of t as t tends to a is equal to limit f double dash of t by g double dash of t as t tends to a, and so on till we find fraction such that when value is substituted, then both numerator and denominator do not vanish, and hence we obtain a result. For example, we have limit sine of 2x by x as x tends to 0. Now if we put the value of x as 0 in this, we get sine of 0 by 0, which is of 0 by 0 form. Now applying L'Hopital's rule, we get limit differentiating sine of 2x with respect to x, that is cos of 2x into differentiating 2x with respect to x, that is 2, upon differentiating the denominator with respect to x, that is differentiating x with respect to x, that is 1, as x tends to 0. On putting the value of x as 0, we get cos of 0 into 2, which is equal to 1 into 2, since cos of 0 is 1, that is 1 into 2, that is 2. So the value of limit sine of 2x by x as x tends to 0 is 2. Other indeterminate forms are infinity by infinity, 0 into infinity, infinity minus infinity, 0 raised to power 0, infinity raised to power 0, 1 raised to power infinity. Let f of a be equal to infinity and g of a is equal to infinity so that f of a by g of a takes the form infinity by infinity when t approaches indefinitely near the value a. Now in such cases we write f of t by g of t is equal to 1 upon g of t whole upon 1 upon f of t. As 1 upon g of t is equal to 1 upon infinity, that is 0, and 1 upon f of t is equal to 1 upon infinity, that is 0. Therefore, we can consider this as taking the form 0 by 0 and can apply L'Hopital's rule. Thus, limit f of t by g of t as t tends to a is equal to limit 1 upon g of t whole upon 1 upon f of t as t tends to a. Differentiate numerator and denominator separately by applying quotient rule of differentiation to both numerator and denominator but separately. We get g of t into 0 minus 1 into g dash of t upon g of t the whole square whole upon f of t into 0 minus of 1 into f dash of t whole upon f of t the whole square. Therefore, limit f of t upon g of t as t tends to a is equal to limit g dash of t upon f dash of t into f of t the whole square by g of t the whole square. As t tends to a, which can be written as limit f of t by g of t as t tends to a is equal to limit f of t by g of t the whole square as t tends to a into limit g dash of t by f dash of t as t tends to a, which is equal to 1 is equal to limit f of t by g of t as t tends to a into limit g dash of t by f dash of t as t tends to a, which is equal to limit f of t by g of t as t tends to a is equal to limit f dash of t by g dash of t as t tends to a. Hence, L'Hopital's rule is also applicable to infinity by infinity form. For example, if we have limit log of x upon x cube as x tends to infinity. Now if we put the value of x as infinity in this expression, we get log of infinity by infinity cube, that is of infinity by infinity form. So applying L'Hopital's rule, we get limit differentiating log of x with respect to x, that is 1 upon x, upon differentiating x cubed with respect to x, that is 3x squared, as x tends to infinity. This can also be written as limit 1 upon 3x cubed as x tends to infinity. Now if we put the value of x as infinity in this expression, we get 0. Now we shall discuss 0 into infinity form. Let f of a be 0 and g of a be infinity, so that f of a into g of a takes the form 0 into infinity when t tends to a, limit f of a into g of a when t tends to a is equal to limit f of a by 1 upon g of a when t tends to a, since 1 upon g of a is equal to 1 upon infinity, that is 0. Therefore, it will take the form 0 by 0, and we can apply L'Hopital's rule . For example, if we have limit x square into log of x as x tends to 0, if we put the value of x as 0 in this expression, we get 0 into log of 0, that is of 0 into infinity form, since log of 0 is equal to minus infinity, which can also be written as limit log of x upon 1 upon x square as x tends to 0. If we put the value of x as 0, we get log of 0 upon 1 upon 0, that is of infinity by infinity form. Now applying L'Hopital's rule, we get limit differentiating log of x with respect to x, that is 1 upon x upon differentiating 1 upon x square with respect to x, we get minus 2 upon x cube. As x tends to 0, this can also be written as limit x square upon minus 2 as x tends to 0. Now if we put the value of x as 0, we get 0 upon minus 2, that is 0. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.